Namaste, welcome to Educate Naturally. Today I have brought you topic regarding the cash management, and under the cash management I will be dealing with the concept cash management cycle, motives and objectives of cash management, effective cash management, and final is cash conversion cycle. Now let's move into the detail. Concept of cash management. In any organization, cash plays a vital role in order to perform their day-to-day activities. So cash is also regarded as lifeblood of any firm, needed to acquire supply resources, equipment and other asset in generating the product and service. So in order to generate or develop the product and service, cash is a vital factor for that company or any organization. So cash management can be defined as efficient collection, disbursement and investment of cash in organization while maintaining the company liquidity. Marketable security also comes under the liquidity, which provides quick cash when needed. So cash management is all about managing organization collection, disbursement and investment of cash. Now finally, cash management is all about mainly three things. So one is collecting cash, next is managing cash, and using cash for the investment. Here the cash management cycle has been shown. In this diagram you can clearly trace out that when there is business operation, then that is followed by the information, then it may result in a cash collection or cash payment. When there is cash collection or the cash payment, two things may arise: deficit and surplus. When there is deficit, then you need to borrow, and when there is surplus, then you need to invest that cash. Now let's move to the next slide, that is motives and objective of cash management. Motive for the cash holding means there are mainly three motive. If you hold a cash for the day-to-day activities, then that may result in a transaction motive. And if you hold the cash for unpredictable obligations such as float or strike, then that comes under the precautionary motive. And when you hold the cash for profit making purpose, then that comes under the speculative motive. Now next is objective of cash management. There are mainly three objectives. One is sufficient liquidity. For having a sufficient liquidity, you need to hold the cash, or you need to maintain cash efficiently in your organization. Second is working capital requirement. For the day-to-day activities, the cash management should be an effective and efficient way in any organization. And final one is short-term requirement, just for example administrative activities. So for that also you need to have a cash management in an effective way. Effective cash management. For effective cash management, I have highlighted some of the things that you need to manage well. First is formulation of cash. You need to formulate the cash in an effective way so that you can meet a day-to-day liquidity requirement. Investment. You need to make a right investment and a profitable investment from the cash that you have. Next is balance in a deposit and loan. You need to have a balance in deposit and loan so that you can maintain a sufficient liquidity. Monitor the cash regularly. You need to monitor the cash regularly so that there may not arise any problem in handling the cash. Encourage faster payment. You need to encourage the faster payment so that you can meet day-to-day requirement, and you can just analyze the daily requirement also. And next is cutting costs. When you cut the cost, the cash can be increased. Availability line of credit. You need to also have a line of credit so that in terms of difficulty you can just borrow from there. And preparing cash budget. You need to prepare the cash budget, your expense, your income, so that can be just helpful in managing your day-to-day activities and just be a better way of maintaining well cash in your organization. This slide is all about the cash conversion cycle. In this slide I have designed you a diagram which will give you a cash conversion. Now when you add a days sales inventory plus days sales in receivable, that's combined comes into the operating cycle minus days payable outstanding, then that will result in cash conversion. So please subscribe the channel this much regarding the topic. Do not forget to subscribe the channel Educate Naturally. Thank you so much.